I'll usually do. Then I'm going to do a move that David Roth popularized. I don't know if he invented it, but actually originally, I think it was even Steve that showed me this. Yeah, years ago. So thanks, Steve. But what you're going to do here is you're going to pull the coins out with the ring finger of your left hand and clip it between these two fingers. Now, this may look or sound complicated, but with a little bit of practice, it isn't. It isn't at all. Pull it out like this. And as you take this coin into this hand, right, ostensibly you're just transferring a coin here and then grabbing another one, point it there, grabbing another one, point it there. But there's a transfer going on. As this coin goes into this hand, this coin feeds this coin to back palm position of this hand. And some of you are going, well, yeah, very simple. And then pull it out of back palm position. And the back palm is a good slight to learn. I mean, I don't like it when you're going like this all the time. I think it looks kind of artificial. But, and that's why I prefer this, I prefer this because the fingers are open more naturally. It just looks more natural. But for this particular situation, I do the transfer, get that there, pull it out. Now, as attention's focused on this, I'm getting another coin ready here. Bring the hands together, transfer. I'm just exchanging one coin for the other. Pull it out, get the third one ready. Now, David Roth, I believe, continues and puts the last one in there and pulls another one out, which to me is not good routine because anytime you have repetition, there's less surprise. Right? Repetition is good for miser's dream or something like that, but for this, I don't like it. So instead, I'll leave this an edge palm, take out these three, and then notice that there's one on the other person's sleeve. And it always gets a laugh because you're pulling point here, and then all of a sudden you pull over there, and then I usually go, yeah, I was there, or something like that. So it wasn't too long, but it's still great. Almost as nice as Bert. So if anyone wants to see this afterwards, I'm happy to go over with you because I realize it's a lot to absorb all at once. I'm also taping this, so. Anyway, so I've produced all the coins now, and then I do the downs plank pass, which is a false transfer, where you go like this, and the coins are still here. And all you're doing there is you're stepping the coins, letting them rest on the pinky finger, and then you're letting them fall. And they just sit there, like on a little shelf. And it's great, you know, because when you do this, you have the noise, and they're in finger palm position, basically, when you finish off with it. So I offer to let someone look at them. They go to look at them, and then I just produce them from back here. Then I usually do a coin roll or something at this point, just to say that there's four coins. There's a number of ways you can do this, and it's written up in any number of books. You can do them singly. You can roll all four at once, just whatever you prefer. Steve does this too, I'm sure. Anyone wants to learn it. Now comes the pocket stuff. Now that it's been established there's four coins, I have these seen in fingertip rest position. I toss them into this hand. But because the bottom point of the stack is making contact with my fingers, it remains there when the other ones fly. This is called the Benzaeus friction pass, I believe is what it's known as. What's that? Yes, thank you. Page 217. All right. So anyways, you've got these tossed over here. Now this is a really cool move. I love this. What you're going to be doing is you're going to be tossing this point into your top but under cover of passing these points back. Now there's a couple of principles in operation here. One is this hand's making a large movement, this one's making a small, so this one's more visual. Secondly, this hand is behind this one. So the object, which is closer to the audience, is the one they'll be focused on. Even if you try and watch this coin, try and focus on this hand. When I go like this, you can't see the coin being tossed in. It's just an optical principle. It's amazing. You can use that for all kinds of stuff. That's what I was using with my pen. So you go like this, you toss this over, and now there's just three coins. You've gotten rid of one secretly in your pocket. Now, with these three here, what you're going to do is you're going to keep your thumb on the two of them and let one of them fly free, like this. And you're going to toss it into your top head on the upsweep and then just toss the other ones down. And you can't tell how many coins are falling down. You can't count them. So, I mean, you know, use as much height as you want on it. But I sort of time it so if there is a clink, it's at the same time these coins are coming down. So now we've got two here. Now, at this point, you have to clean out your top head because start throwing stuff in there. It's going to make noise at this point. So I let people examine. this one like a cymbal and falls into the hand, right? And if you catch it on your toe, it's really impressive. That time. So that's what you're doing, it's a quick pass. And you see the coin flying there. Now there's two ways of doing this. You can go on placing one coin in there and placing two in there, and then you can make them separate, which should be a standard magical presentation. The way I prefer to do it is act like I'm caught. So I, all right, so remember in a moment, they're gonna end up in the same hand, you know, and then they think they, oh, I heard something, they start looking at each other, oh, did you hear that? And then I go, oh yeah, you heard that, you know, I say, okay, I better start over. So now I'm correcting a problem that occurred. And so there's a reason, there's motivation to the magic. And so it's much stronger that way. It's, it defines your character in a different way as well. I prefer to do it that way. Then the last one is just a variation of that. Right? It's confusing to people. You know, when you ask them what happened after, they go, the coin was in his mouth, and it disappeared from there, and it ended up in his hand, and there was a rabbit running by. You know, it's just that it creates a different impression on them. But by pointing in your mouth, then you can make the joke, it gets better, about sleight of mouth and stuff. Okay, so much for that. Now, at this point, I got two coins. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this one here, and make it disappear as well. And I'm just going to be tossing the coin into my pocket. I guess they think I have two. I go, I've got one in my hand, one here. I'll just do it with one. Okay. Right? And that one kills people. They're just like, what? So you got one here, you got this one here. It's now on your palm. On the way up to here, you just toss it into your top and go like that. And they're like, what? You know, really, they go, there were two there. So then you just do a bunch of different vanishes. Sort of similar to Spellbound, that one I do where I'm holding it sideways in my hand, just like drop down in the finger palm position under cover of this coin grabbing it. And this is a LaPaul vanish, I think, from the magic of LaPaul. Where you take the coin like this. And to me, it's really effective because, I mean, they see the coin falling into the hand. You know, boom, they think it's there. And what you're doing is you're letting it rotate the half rotation and land on your pinky. Just like this, and then you're stealing it back, like that. It's a half rotation on the pinky, and then stealing it back. Yeah, so that's a good one. I was doing that. The last one, where I'm doing the steal. Boom, like that. I love this little thing. Let me just take my hand a little bit. It's in the lecture notes, too, how to make these, but these are really cool. Little squeakers, and you get a lot of mileage out of them, especially in a walk around situation, because it's fantastic. You know, I rather feel like, you know, there's just all types of games, you know, and stuff, you know. And you're just hanging it with your arm. You know, clowns have been using these for years, and I think it's time that we as magicians started learning more about clowning, don't you agree? Well, I'm way too far behind in that regard. Alright, with the last steal, boom, like this. Standard body steal, all you want to do is focus attention in one area by your body language and by your arm, your eye, and everything. While the other hand just goes back like this and just pulls the coin. Okay, so obviously if I've done this, boom, as I reach like this, everyone's watching there, this hand is right back here just grabbing the coin. I've now got it hidden in my hand like this. And to change them, I go from here to here. All I'm doing is I'm rotating this out, right, from this position, like this. And if you hold your hand out, just hold your hand out, like that, yeah, palm up, yeah. I go, now watch this coin. When it goes from here to here, that's when it happens. Sometimes if he gets airtime to it, it's absolutely amazing. Now they're watching that. With this coin here, I just come up with my hands like this. I toss it in the pocket, you know, it's going. And you're going, oh yeah, absolutely.
We need to do it.
Yeah, absolutely. No, I'd be happy.
You've got 5 minutes to show us.
Sure. Yeah. I'll show you what it is first of all, and I'll show you how to do it. The palm proper is like this. The muscle pass moves it a little bit closer towards the thumb. Okay. The angle of action is between the bone of this thumb here and the pinky knuckle right here. Imagine a line right there. So the coin's in that line, a little bit closer to the thumb than the palm. just enough skin there so that it just hugs the coin. If it's too deep, you know, the coin will like just roll over, it won't flip. And if it's not enough, of course, it just does a little flip too. So that's what you have to practice doing. Then you need to press down like this, and you can get some good height on these coins. And this is a heavy silver dollar. Take a look at that. I mean, that's got some weight to it, you know, and yet you can still pop it up really nicely. Thank you. It's sometimes funny too, if you drop something, you go to pick it up, you go.
Sensational,
right, Dave? Okay, all right. All you're going to do is you bring this leave a little space here for you to grab one of the short ends. Okay, because you come up and then the hands come apart and you've apparently restored it when in fact you've just grabbed the short end.
Edward Victor's move.
Yes, Edward Victor, Magic of the Hands. Right. Thank you. Further footnote. Now, there's another phase you can go into at this point if you want, where you grab this here, sort of midway between these two. You run your hand down here until this is about midway, and then you're just going to take the short loop and grab it in your hand like this, and so now you just put the short loop back on top again, and you can cut it.